Dear learners, welcome to this session. In this session, we will discuss the one of the quadrant of four quadrant approaches. So, in this session, we will discuss about the assessment in online programs or in MOOC program. So, let us discuss the one of the component of assessment, that is objective type of assessment. In the objective type of assessment, there are various types of assessments are there. Here we will discuss why we required assessment and why we required the objective type of assignments and objective type of questions, and what are the different types of objective type questions. That also we will discuss here. The objective questions are a method of assessing student to select correct response from the options, or to respond by word or respond by a short phrase, to answer the question or to fill up the gap in the statement. So, the marking is a very simple process, either evaluate manually or by using the computer. So, sometimes for this online program, everything will be the online based and computer based assessment. So, student can just click on the correct answer if it is a multiple choice or questions, or otherwise they can just simply fill the gap to answer the question. There are various type of objective questions like multiple choice, true or false, filling the blanks, match the following, and so on. You have to select appropriate type to match with the content. That is very important. So, this type of assessment help to measure the student's knowledge, critical thinking, problem solving skill as a learning outcome. So, once you have defined the learning outcome for that particular course, in order to test the learning outcome, you can design this type of objective questions to test the knowledge and the critical and problem solving of the student. So, let me discuss multiple choice questions. The multiple choice question where will give the alternatives to identify the appropriate answer or answers. Even if you can select one as a correct answer, or more than one also, you can set the alternative for that particular question. So, for example, if it is a multiple choice question, the question will have the question stump, that is a question, and after that you will have options, maybe 4 options, 3 options, and otherwise also 5 options, depends upon how you are creating the options. And in that particular options, one will be the correct answer, or more, one or two may be a correct answer, you can fix it. And other 3 or 4 also, they are called as a distractors. So, one multiple question have a question stem, options, correct answer, distractors. These will form a multiple choice question. So, the following idea can be used by the teacher while constructing the MCQs. The question should be more precise, clear, and concise with in a word and phrase, choice or options. So, these are the basically main focus should be to very precise and clear with the phrase as well as the choices. The correct answer should be one among the choices so that it can be select from the options given to the student. And you can give the at least 3 to 5 reasonable choices or options for the student to select the answer from the choice or option. All the above or none of the above can be avoided in the choices, because why it is very important in the computer based MCQs. If it is a pen and paper, then all the above will be coming at the last choice of any question. If you are giving the computer based MCQ, that may be the computer may, you can give the option to shuffle the options also. If you are giving the options, the selecting, shuffling in between the options, then all the above will come sometimes in the top of the option, and none of the above also sometimes may be in between or in the top of the question. If you are giving these two in the option, this should be always in the bottom of your choices. So, when you are giving the choices, you have to very much careful of giving these two options. This can be very much avoided for the computer-based MCQs. The MCQs must test the knowledge, application, comprehension, analysis and evaluation, which is a Bloom's taxonomy. We have to give all the options. You can design a question to test the knowledge, test the applications and comprehensions, and test the analysis. If the student can, you can evaluate the knowledge using the MCQs to achieve the learning outcome of the subject. And next, coming to the true or false questions. So examples are, you can state whether the true or false, the source code of Free Mind is open. That is a question. The student can select either true or false based on the statement. There is only two options for them. Either they have to say true or they have to say false. So, this can be that apart from this true or false, this can be agree, disagree, or this can be yes or no. And like that, you can frame the question according to the sentence or phrase. And we will coming to the filling the blanks question. Filling the blanks questions involve the student to know the correct answer rather than selecting from the list of the possible answer. Whereas here they have to exactly know the correct answer to fill the gap. They will not get any option to select from that. So the student will have more knowledge or more learning to answer the filling the blank type of questions. So, this type of question has only one possible correct answer to avoid the misconception and difficulty to give mark. Suppose if you want to test the whether the student has the misconception of the content, then you can frame the filling the blank so that the student will clear about the concept to fill the gap for that particular statement. The blank should be placed appropriately in the question or statement. The question or statement should recall the important information learnt in the subject. So, that is very important where you are giving, where to place the filling the blank question to test the subject. For example, the learning can be consist as a dash that student has to fill the appropriate answer, give the answer to this type of question. So, here the answer is process. So, the learning can be considered as the process by which knowledge, skill, attitude are acquired, understood and applied and extended. So, in this way you can create a filling the blank questions. Then coming to the matching the test. The matching exercise consists of two parallel columns with each word, number or symbol in one column be matched with the other, matched to the word, sentence or phrases in the other column. So, there should be a table column. In one side will be proper requirement and another side will be the answer which will be jumbled form. So, the student has to match that appropriate answer from column A to column B. The question or statement in the column for which a match is sought are called promises, and the item in the column from which the selection is made are called the responses. So, I repeat again, the question or statement in the column for which a match is sought are called premises, and the item in the column from which the selection is made are called the responses. The basis of the match the following must be explain in the direction, maybe in the direction. The student task is to identify the pair of items that are to be associated to the basic indicated. For example, if you can say that match the following, one side the answer is for the cloth, what type of clothes are available, like a silk, cotton, nylon, leather and wool. So, that is listed here. And 1 to 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, that is numbering is there. And this side, that is the answers are, that means responses are jumbled in a five item. You can give five or you can give more than five also. From that, the student can select the appropriate answer. So answer can be given like this: 1-B, that is for one answer is B, and for two answer is D, like that the student can give. Or otherwise they can draw line if it is a response in on the paper. But if it is a computer based, match the following. The drag and drop method is there, and they can drag it to the particular correct answer, should be dragged and placed it into the particular line. For example, for 6 silk, that the answer B can be dragged and placed it in the first position. Like that, the computer system allow you to match the question with the appropriate place. We have explained the various type of objective test questions. Apart from also, sometimes the small type of one word answer or definition also can be asked in the objective type of questions. In the developing the MOOC program, so objective types are very much important to for the self testing. For student can themselves whether they can go in the right direction of their learning. So every week or alternative week, the objective type questions will be placed quiz form or otherwise in the assignment form. They can be placed in the MOOC courses so that the student can test themselves. Later you can take that objective type for the continuous assessment also. That is also possible to take as an internal mark for that particular course. So student can, you can take best out of 3 self assessment, or otherwise specially you can create a match the following, or otherwise multiple choice question, filling the blanks and the true or false question to based on the subject. You can select any one type of test, and then you can appropriate place in the online platform so that the student can test themselves, and then they can, if they are not able to perform well, then they read again the content and then come back, they'll test themselves again and again to fulfill the requirement. With this, end with the session. Thank you.